I'm Jeremy Michalek, and I direct Carnegie Mellon's Vehicle Electrification Group. Electrified vehicles have the potential to improve energy security, air quality, climate change, and economics. These are key priorities in the United States. The U.S. imports about 9 million barrels of petroleum per day, and transportation accounts for 70% of that demand. Air pollution from tailpipes and smokestacks causes thousands of dollars of damage per vehicle to human health, the environment, and infrastructure. Transportation and electricity generation together account for more than half of U.S. greenhouse gas emissions that contribute to climate change. And electric vehicles have economic implications. Fuel cost is about half as much for electric vehicles as for equivalent gasoline vehicles. Electricity is produced primarily from domestic energy sources. And there are also competitive benefits to leading technology innovation. But are plug-in electric vehicles better than other technologies for achieving these goals? Sometimes, but not always. The answer depends on several critical factors that vary from region to region or from driver to driver, such as where you get your electricity, when you charge, how you drive, what type of climate you live in, what type of vehicle you drive, and what policies are in place. Since 2008, we've conducted studies to understand and characterize the implications of these factors on the costs and benefits of electric vehicles in the United States. I'll summarize a few of our recent findings. First, it's important to understand how the electricity used to charge an electric vehicle is generated. Some regions generate electricity primarily from high-emission coal-fired power plants, while other regions draw more heavily from cleaner sources. For example, an electric vehicle charged in the northern Midwest can produce 2 to 3 times as much carbon dioxide as the same vehicle charged on the West Coast. So, while an electric Nissan Leaf produces fewer greenhouse gas emissions than the gasoline Toyota Prius in the western U.S. and in Texas, the opposite is true in the coal-heavy northern Midwest. Also important is when you charge. Charging electric vehicles at night can lower electricity generation costs by a quarter to a third in places like Chicago, Washington, D.C., and Philadelphia, because more inexpensive coal-fired power plants are available at night. But the resulting emissions from these plants produce human health costs that exceed any savings. This could change in the future with sufficient coal plant retirement and wind power capacity. The benefits of electric vehicles also depend on how you drive. For stop-and-go city driving, hybrid and plug-in electric vehicles could cut greenhouse gas emissions in half on average, while lowering lifetime costs. But for highway cruising, the same vehicles cost more with marginal environmental benefit. Even the weather affects electric vehicle benefits. Electric vehicles consume an average of 15% more electricity in extreme weather regions like Phoenix or Minneapolis than on the balmy West Coast. On the coldest or hottest days, plug-in electric vehicle range can drop by 40% or more. Also, different types of electrified vehicles have different implications. For example, a typical gasoline vehicle may generate around $4,000 of costs to society over its life due to the impact of air emissions on human health and the environment. A hybrid electric vehicle, which uses gasoline more efficiently, or a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, which uses electricity for short trips and gasoline for long trips, could lower these costs by 15 to 30%, depending on the electricity source. In contrast, a pure battery electric vehicle, which relies entirely on electricity, could either cut these costs in half or double them, depending on the battery and the electricity source. Inexpensive hybrids tend to offer more air emissions and oil displacement benefits per dollar spent. Finally, public policy can dramatically affect the implications of electric vehicle adoption. For example, today's federal fuel economy policy allows automakers that sell plug-in vehicles to meet less stringent fleet fuel economy standards. So when one consumer opts for a plug-in vehicle, it allows other consumers to purchase higher emitting vehicles than they would have been able to otherwise. The net effect is that each time an electric vehicle is sold in the United States in place of a gasoline vehicle, overall greenhouse gas emissions from the vehicle fleet increase by up to 60 metric tons of CO2, and U.S. gasoline consumption increases by up to 7,000 gallons or more, at least through 2025 while these incentives are in place. So, electric vehicles have the potential to offer advantages in reducing emissions, improving energy security, and providing economic benefits. But in practice, they could have a net positive or net negative effect relative to the most efficient gasoline vehicles, depending on a range of factors. To achieve the best outcomes, adoption should typically be focused on hybrid and plug-in hybrid electric vehicles by city drivers in mild climate regions with a clean electricity grid, such as San Francisco or Los Angeles. And drivers should not be encouraged to charge at night in coal-heavy regions. However, because of federal fuel economy policy, even in the best scenario, the net effect of U.S. plug-in electric vehicle adoption may still be to increase emissions and gasoline consumption, at least through 2025. The hope is that in the long run, as the electric power grid becomes cleaner, as electric vehicles become cheaper and faster to recharge with longer range, and as policies adjust, that electrification will offer benefits across the board. But the competition is a moving target since gasoline, diesel, and alternative fuel vehicles also improve over time. To achieve energy security, air quality, climate change, and economic goals, policies that target these goals directly, rather than favoring specific technologies, have the potential to be more efficient in managing the types of variations in benefits I've described, while avoiding unintended consequences. At Carnegie Mellon, we're working to train the next generation of professionals, innovators, scholars, and leaders. For more information on these and other studies, visit cmu.edu/CIT/VEG or search for CMU VEG.